Could I have your attention, please? Can you hear me? All right, everyone, please find your seats. I'd like to get started on today's Match Day 2023 celebration. For those who don't know me, I'm Dr. Kevin Cavanaugh. I help the students through this complex match process, and it culminates in today, Match Day 2023. Welcome, all of you. I want to run through the agenda. Don't worry, I'm not giving a speech. You got other people giving speeches. I'm just up here to kind of warm up the crowd and get everybody seated. Kind of like when you go to a really nice concert, you know, you get the crappy warm-up band first, and they kind of warm people up, and so that's me. So we'll have two speakers, Dean Paula and Ainsley McWilliams from your class. We'll then have a video, which was produced by the students, and it's kind of a fun event. Shortly after that, we'll have a countdown, and yes, there will be champagne distributed at about 11:45 during the video. And then at noon, and that's noon Eastern time, at least for us, there will be, you'll have to go back to the back in there where your t-shirts are and get your envelopes. And at noon exactly, we'll have a countdown to noon, and then we'll be opening the envelopes, all right? That is a nationwide event, so it's even happening at 9 a.m. in California. You know, I mean, they're barely awake. They're just getting their $12 lattes, and they got to go open envelopes and et cetera. So it's all across the nation. The one thing I'd ask is you put your cell phones either in vibrate or off mode. It can be nuts at noon. There's all these phones exploding and, you know, phone calls from all over the world, literally. And so it kind of disrupts the event a little bit if that happens. Happy Match Day. Happy St. Patrick's Day. As someone who's lived in Ireland, I got to go there, and it kind of helps. So thanks for that. How many, just show of hands, how many are Irish by heritage? I see some green out there. Any? Okay. How many are Irish for one day today only? A lot of hands. All right. So top of the morning to you. Ah, no. When, if you're going to be Irish today, when they say top of the morning to you, your response is, and the rest of the good day to you. All right, so top of the morning to you. Not a pass. It's a high pass, not honors, but high pass. We'll take it. All right, Irish are pretty smart, you know. And in fact, it always befuddled me. So they're smart, but they've never been able to calculate. Ireland's largest city, they've never been able to calculate the population. They've tried and tried. And you're like, why is that? Because it's always Dublin. All right. No more Irish jokes till you've had some champagne. So, but no, it's not about the Irish. Did I just say that? It's about the students. Students, class of 2023. You've gone through this complex match process, lots of steps, lots of letters, and lots of personal statements, and application after application. The good news today, you don't have to ask for any more letters of reference. Yeah, finally. And at noon, you'll know where you're going. So congratulations. It's a beautiful day. We have Irish weather outside. We have a beautiful venue inside. Stryker stock is up 23 cents a share. So I can't be better. Welcome, all of you. I know you have friends and family from all over the world, literally, and welcome all of you to Kalamazoo. We really appreciate you being here to celebrate with us, and I hope you enjoy this. This is today about the students. You know, there's an old phrase that said it's not all about you. Students, it is all about you today. So congratulations.
Well, let's let the fun begin. Hi, I'm Dr. Paula Tremulin. I have the great honor of being the dean of the Western Michigan University Homer Stryker MD School of Medicine. And right now, one of my greatest hopes for our students is that they've matched in places where that rolls off the tongue a little easier. Because you're always going to be part of our WMed family. Now, I graduated in 1989, so it was this week, back in 1989, that I sat in all of your shoes. I matched into general surgery. And, you know, it was an exciting time. Those photographs still sit in my bind. I actually have albums, so I know there's parents out there that know what those look like, the physical binders and so forth. And I, there's a photograph of me and three other of the women in my class. We had all matched into surgery, and we took the knives from the table. We were at the Spaghetti Warehouse in St. Louis, where I was going to school. And we actually like put the knives in and had this like photograph of the four of us. Ironically, two of the four of us, I think, ended up in other disciplines. And the other two, one you see standing before you, and the other is a faculty member at St. Louis University. So we either went sort of like, you know, big hit, go big or go to something else is what happened over time. So I also really want to extend a welcome to all of you from near and far. How many Californians do we have in the room? There we are. Thank you for joining us in the Upper Midwest here on Match Day. Do we have any Floridians? Maybe? Okay. All right. Do we have any Canadians? Because this weather will be familiar to you. All right. Okay. And, you know, this is such a special day and actually a little bit different than when I was going through Match Day. My husband and I were at that dinner. You know, we really didn't invite families and friends like we do today. And it's really been such an inclusive experience because we all know that our students stand on the shoulders of the people that support them. So let's have a round of applause for all those folks. So as Dr. Kavanaugh already pointed out, you know, it's a very dramatic day. There's a reason why television shows and movies are made about medical training and doctors. And Match Day has all that drama with it, right? We're going to open envelopes at noon, et cetera. But there's a whole lot of, like, history behind the match. So I thought I'd share a little bit of that, particularly for those that have not, you know, for those that may not have experience with it. So the MATCH program began in 1952, and it created this centralized system for placing applicants into training programs. Now, prior to that, you would, for all of you who've been out there interviewing, right, can you imagine showing up at your first interview and the program director says, sign on the dotted line today? And in fact, that's why the MATCH was created. It's actually been challenged over the years because of restrictions of trade and a whole bunch of other things that people have said we don't get to say about our contracts. But as someone who was a residency program director for about 13 years in my past and been on the other side and advised many, many students over the years, I cannot imagine a process where you would have to decide in the moment when you got those interviews, because I know how challenging it is right now to go through that process. So we've had 70 years of success with the MATCH. There are more than 10,000 programs per year in all the different specialties that move through this process, and more than 50,000 applicants, okay? Because remember, it's not just our US medical grads, right? So there's actually 50,000 applicants that move through all those different programs. As usual, I can tell you that our 2023 main residency match is the largest in the National Residency Matching Program's 70-year history. This year, there were a record of 40,375 positions in the match. So we know that as medical schools like WMed have come online, we've increased the number of graduates, we need more placements. We have done modest amounts of that. So at least now, it's almost one-to-one. So we know that you will find a spot, whereas in the not-so-distant past, you may not have actually gotten a spot. Because another thing we know is that 99% of you in the graduating class of 2023 have matched, and that one percenter has chosen a little different path to, you know, to go into their specialty. So some of you are going to stay here in Michigan. Some of you are going to stay here with us at WMed, because I've seen the list. Some will go across the country, and we're going to have 23 different states represented. 23. So, round of applause for that. Half the country. Thirty-seven of you are going to be in primary care. It's really important that we continue to produce, primary care physicians. All right. So in order to make all of these matches, there's actually a mathematical algorithm that is utilized. So, you know, applicants go through and they rank their list. the programs go through and they rank their applicants, and then, you know, the magic happens in the big computer, so to speak. It's probably really tiny these days, but and it's a proprietary formula that the history of which is that it actually has won the Nobel Prize. So in 2012, so as an economist, Dr. Roth, who helped create it, and then an economist, Dr. Lloyd Shapley, won the Nobel Prize in Economics for the algorithmic work, and it's been honored as an outstanding example of actually economic engineering, because not only does this algorithm get used to match graduates of medical schools with their residency programs, but it also has been used in adapted ways for matching kidneys with patients, school admissions. The State Department actually uses this now for to place foreign service members around the world. So there's a there's a wide variety of utilizations of the algorithm that brought you to this room today. Let's see, what else can we tell you here that might be of interest? So last year, there were a total of about 15,745 applicants matched in family medicine, internal medicine, pediatrics. So essentially 46% of all those first year matches were in those primary care specialties. If you want to know what your top five were last year that seniors matched into, internal medicine with 3,739, pediatrics with about 1,700, emergency medicine about 1,600, family medicine around 1,500, and anesthesiology almost 1,300. You might ask, because some of you were, I'm not going to have a show of hands of how many people interviewed at more than, let's say, 30 places, but I know there's some of you out there. Okay, those would be those individuals that wanted to pursue specialties that are a little bit more competitive. So those would include specialties like medicine, which is combined with emergency medicine, medicine pediatrics, we have one of those programs at WMed, interventional radiology, where you match into that right out of medical school, neurosurgery, orthopedic surgery, otolaryngology, physical medicine and rehab has become increasingly competitive. Integrated plastic surgery, where you start that training immediately out of medical school, in addition to thoracic and vascular surgery, those are other integrated tracks, and diagnostic radiology. So those are the ones that have had some of the most challenging routes into those specialties. Since 2013, the average length rank order list for our matched seniors has increased almost 30%. And we see that as a real challenge. So when I talk about how, when Dr. Kavanaugh spoke to how much work you've been through, I know how much work you've been through. It doesn't help anybody in this room right now, except to say that we are aware how hard it is to figure out, first of all, what you want to do, and then to actually get into it. And thankfully, for the most part, we've switched to virtual interviews, which has really reduced the financial burden for many of you as you've gone through this process. So I'm hoping that someday one of you out there, maybe standing on a podium like I am, or sitting in the seats like many of our faculty are here today, and welcoming the next class, or welcoming the students and cheering with them for where they've matched, okay? And so along those lines, I want to take a moment, because we really could not do this without our faculty. So could all the faculty in the room please stand? I don't care whether we employ you or you're one of our community faculty. Please stand, and let's give them a round of applause. Because not only have they gone, you know, in your classrooms and taught you on your clinics and so forth, they've also, I know, go above and beyond to really help support you where you end up. Okay. So, the work is done, the applications went in, you put in your rank order lists, and it's about time for the fun to begin. So, congratulations to all of you, so that we can help celebrate with you as you find out the what you're going to do and the where you're going to do it. So, congrats. Ainsley, yep, come on up.
Okay. everyone. I just heard that there is money on how long into this speech it takes me to cry. So if you haven't placed your bets, please do so now. Welcome, friends, family, faculty, and all of my fellow students to Match Day. We're here. My name is Ainsley McWilliams, and I am so very fortunate to be a member of the WMed class of 2023. Before I get started, let me just say, for formality's sake, Dr. Fails, the scene is safe. It was incredibly hard for me to try and sit down and write any kind of speech for you today. My instinct was to be ridiculous and start with, "We did it," from Legally Blonde, but I think you guys are all too young and wouldn't get the reference. And Samuel told me that if I didn't take this seriously, he would supplant me as speaker, and I couldn't let my limelight get away. So I'm gonna do my best to be serious. We have been through a lot in the last 4 years. It's hard right now in this moment to think back on those memories when we're just literally minutes away from finding out what we're going to do with the rest of our lives. But I'm gonna ask that you all take a minute with me and relive some of our highlights. What can I say? I'm a little bit nostalgic. I think I can speak for all of us when I say we're all very fortunate that we ended up here at WMed. So I'd like to say thank you so much to Gene Shelton for bringing us all together. And we are all, yes, Gene. And we are all very hashtag glad to be here. Beginning medical school is really intimidating. The learning curve is, well, they kept saying in orientation, it's like drinking from a fire hose. We quickly learn from Dr. Larson that genes are not just made from denim. The mitochondria is indeed the powerhouse of the cell, and apparently kind of more complicated than we thought. We learned the ultimate truism of medical school, that the more stressed a medical student becomes, the more beverages accumulate on their desk. We became proficient in basic coding to optimize our Anki decks, or if you were like me, copy and pasting from someone else. All the while, we enjoyed endless ping pong tournaments and fast friendships over fried food at Harvey's and Old P. But of course, you know, we can't talk about the medical school we've gone through without talking about the elephant in the room. And I do not mean the impending coup by the five Rachels to overthrow the Lorber presidency. I'm of course talking about COVID. It's kind of strange to talk about COVID as our own particular hardship, right? On one hand, it almost seems crass. We've been so fortunate in so many ways in this profession. We still got to do our clinical rotations. As medical professionals, we had the first access to the vaccine and a return to normalcy. We've been protected in those ways, right? But at the same time, like everyone else in the world, we've lost loved ones. We've had our lives turned completely upside down. We've been isolated from these newfound friendships that mean so much, and we had to reimagine our entire worldview. But I've never been prouder to be part of this community than I have been seeing how all of us rose to meet those challenges. I've seen my classmates spend hours and hours of their own time vaccinating this community. And they all have the Facebook post to prove it, if you want to check. I've seen us band together in the wake of George Floyd and stand up for this community, this home that we have built in Kalamazoo, by forming White Coats for Black Lives, for rallying in Bronson Park. And what I'm even more proud of is that these initiatives aren't just a flash in the pan, right? We've continued to be dedicated to helping our neighbors and calling out injustices wherever and whenever we see them. It's an outlook that we will take from WMed wherever we go. I'd like to say a special thank you to Dr. Dixon and Dr. Gibb for your stellar example of teaching us how to be physician advocates. I've also seen us blossom as clinicians over the last year and a half, as we finally got to dip our toes into clinical medicine. Transitioning from performing an abdominal exam on a pillow to actual patients it was daunting, right? But again, we rose to the task, whether it was glowing in the pride of identifying the colon in the OR for the first time. And before you laugh that that was simple, we did learn anatomy on Zoom, and I'm still proud of that. So I think I should, I will remain proud of that. Or some of us making connections with scared children and helping them realize that, you know, going to the doctor doesn't have to be scary, and it might even be a little bit fun. We survived 24-hour surgical calls, OB nights, with some more wrinkles, a few more gray hairs, but we've all come out with the same compassion and empathy that drove us to do medicine in the first place, which I think is a testament unto itself about everyone in this room. I'm tempted, out of my very overwhelming love for all of you, to act like Lindsay Lohan at the end of Mean Girls, when she names everyone and their accomplishments and breaks the crown to little pieces and calls you each up to get recognized. But that's not time efficient, and I think we all wish I was talking a little bit less and not a little bit more. So instead, I'm gonna ask us to do this. Enjoy this moment in time. It seems like we've been waiting so long to just get this over with so we can go on to what's next. But right now, we have a moment to breathe. We have some time to enjoy and revel in everything we've accomplished. There's a poem by one of my favorite authors, and I recently found out one of my classmates' least favorite, Rupi Kaur, that says this very well. I will never have this version of me again. Let me just slow down and be with her. So that is what I hope we all have a chance to do today. While it seems like our identity and our future and everything is determined by what's in the envelope we're going to open in a few short minutes, that's not the whole story of what's happened here. You are all amazing future physicians. We're ready for this. We have all made it to this point together, right? So let's just enjoy the fact that we have accomplished so much and give ourselves a moment of triumph before we blunder through intern year. So I just like to say to the class of 2023, one, I haven't cried yet. Happy match day. May the odds be ever in your favor. Thank you so much for your time. I'm going to go ahead and introduce one of my favorite classmates, Andrew Lynch, who's going to come up and introduce our next moment. Thank you, everyone, so much.
Oh, I lost a lot of money on that bet. Hi, everybody. My name is Andrew Lynch. I'm here on behalf of Student Council to introduce our Match Day video. The Match Day video is a great tradition that we have at WMed. This year, it was passed on to the Student Council to put together, and we enlisted so many of your help in this. We had the vision and an idea and some excitement, but no idea how to make a video. And for that, I'd like to recognize Ian Donmeyer. Is Ian in the crowd over there? Ian is an incredible member of our WMed staff who was excited to take on this project, put it together, and really what you see on the screen right now is a labor of his love and dedication to this project. So on behalf of Student Council and the student body, thank you to Ian, and please enjoy the 2023 Match Day video.
And now, Western Michigan University Homer Stryker MD School of Medicine presents the Match Day 2023 pregame show. Here are your hosts, Peter Beck and Ainsley McWilliams.
Welcome to our game day coverage of Match Day 2023, where we'll give you all of the exclusive highlights and insights from this year's draft. Ainsley, it really has been an absolute roller coaster of an application season, hasn't it?
You know, you've got that right, Peter. Lots of highs, lots of lows. From interviews at top choice programs to the endless, and I mean endless, late night virtual social hours. But these M4s have really come out on top, and they're ready to make an impact at the next level of training.
Booyah! And what a squad of M4s they were. We could spend the entire show highlighting the accomplishments of each applicant in their 3 years at WMed. But right now, we're going to throw it down to our colleague, Mr. Dr. Baller, who's at the Match Day Games, where eager students are warming up and honing their skills before the big match.
Thanks, Petey. Like you said, the students are ready, they're hungry, and they're just getting started. They have done years of studying. They have put in dozens of applications, and that has led to at least one interview. They are ready to get that envelope. That one envelope is the result of all their years of work, and they're gonna find out where in the country they're gonna go.
It's almost like the Oscars, isn't it?
Yeah, if the Oscars were decided by a computer and they're gonna decide where you spend the next years of your life and where you have to buy a house.
Boom goes the dynamite. Tell us, what's it looking like down there?
I'm here with student Dr. Haley
she's
Barker.
Frowning.
And how are you feeling about today's match?
Oh, you know, there's no single life event that compares to how excited I am today.
All right, back to you guys in the studio.
Thanks for the update. We're now joined in studio by Dr. Gomes for some in-depth analysis from the intubation relay. From a scouting perspective, we look for certain intangibles in all of these applicants. Work ethic, attention to detail, knowing when to prescribe lisinopril versus an IUD. What are you seeing going down on the field right now?
Adaptability, quickness, these moves we're seeing, I certainly was not expecting such mature decision-making skills.
Just look at those physician-adjacent reflexes. These are the kind of things that you see that let you know these applicants are ready for residency.
Tell me, how do you rank these applicants and who do you have at the top of your list?
This is a no-brainer, Peter. A lot of times I look for personal history taking skills, oral presentation skills, professionalism on and off the court, just like this applicant here. Great history, knack for procedures, makes them a first choice lock.
Peter, I think this applicant's gonna do very well in surgery. They've got a powerful combination of manual dexterity and swift decision making. I spoke to their mother earlier today and they've been living off Celsius since the age of 4. It's in their veins now.
You should call them Butter, because they are on a roll. Finally, let's not forget this star from MedPeds. They have an uncanny ability not to decide if they wanted to care for adults or kids, so they chose both. And why not? You're double boarded and better than the rest of us. Our team was on the field catching up with them earlier today.
Thanks, Beccaruni. I'm here with student Dr. Nirvan Shankar, who just finished his run here at the Match Day Games. What the audience wants to know, student doctor, is how do you go about preparing for a match like this?
Practice? Man, we ain't talking about practice. Tim, all I can say is that my team and I, we've been preparing for 3 years for this, man. We've been working our butts off, and we have crushed it today. It's match day.
Woo! Okay, back to you guys in the studio.
Well, the future holds endless possibilities for this year's crop of talent. But while they are undoubtedly a bundle of nerves and excitement today, let's hope they don't lose sight of all the futures they have already been a part of, or the ones they almost weren't a part of. Ainsley, I understand we have some breaking news.
Yes, indeed. We now go live to the Dean of WMed, Paula Termulin. Dean Termulin, what can you tell us?
Thanks, Peter and Ainsley. I'm here to announce that the envelopes are in and it's match day. So without further ado.
Yes! Yes!
Okay, calm down. No one get a paper cut.
Very creative, thank you. I'd like to tell students, if you could all go back to the table in the back where they're waving their arms, pick up your envelope. Do not open it yet, all right? We'll have a countdown on the screens down to noon, and then you can open at noon. Should be receiving champagne to your tables right now. Are you ready? Woo! You waited years for this. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Open the envelopes! Woo! Congratulations. All right. One more time. Congrats. If you haven't already consumed your champagne, I think most of you beat us to it. If you haven't already, I'd like to simply take a moment and propose a toast to the graduating class of 2023. Can we raise our glasses and happy match day to everyone? Hooray! I have four items to announce. If I could have your attention for a moment, please. You've probably noticed there's food at either side of the auditorium, of the ballroom. T-shirts are in the back for students. Please make sure and get a T-shirt. Third thing, there's a bulletin board up here on my left. If you want to take a pin and put a pin in the place where you're matched, we would appreciate that. Then we get a kind of a look at the United States of where everyone's going. Fourth thing, if you would like to take the mic and come up and announce your match, please come up and do so. Entirely voluntary. But if you'd like to come up and announce to the crowd where you've matched, we would love to hear that. So, okay, thank you.
So I'll make an announcement, which is we know that five of you are staying with us at WMed, and so we're really excited. Woo! Who wants to share where they've gone? You guys comfortable? Come on up. First of all, we got St. Patrick's Day happening here. Double green.
We matched on perfect, on purpose. On purpose. Okay, I feel bad for going up first, but I'm Ainsley, and I matched Cincinnati for OB-GYN, so I'm going home. Woo-hoo! All right. Hi, everyone. I'm Rachel Z, and I'm going to be going into anesthesiology at University of California, Davis.
All right, don't be shy. All right, maybe we'll just go ahead and like walk through the crowd. We got one.
All right. Yeah, we'll go up on stage. So I guess we'll do it individually.
No.
Okay. I'm James. Couples matching here with Maya. And I matched PM&R at Medical College of Wisconsin.
And I'm Maya. I match pediatrics also at Medical College of Wisconsin.
All right, who else wants to tell us where they're going? Got one? All right.
Hello, everyone. I'm so happy for all of you. I am proud to announce that I'm going home to United Hospital, St. Paul, Minnesota. And I'm going to be a family doctor.
Congratulations. All right, who else is next? Come on, don't be shy. Here we go.
Oh, I'm Krishna, and I'm matching psychiatry at New York Metropolitan.
I don't know why I have to open that.
I'm Corey Mecklenburg, and I got into pathology at Cedars-Sinai.
I'm Zena Kriakos, and I match general surgery at Baylor Dallas.
Dude, you killed it.
My name is Amir. I matched in anesthesiology at University of Washington in Seattle.
I'm James Southard. This feels like a dream. I'm going to Spectrum MedPeds, my number one choice for residency, up in Grand Rapids.
Hi, everyone. I'm Matt Cornes. Congrats to everyone who matched, got to their dream programs. I can't believe I get to say this, but I matched internal medicine at the Mayo Clinic in Jacksonville, Florida.
Hi, my name is Maggie Smith, and after living in Kalamazoo, going to Kalamazoo College, and then WMed, I am going to the University of Rochester in New York for pathology. Any more takers?
Bethany?
Oh, me?
You got it.
Me, it's me.
I'm doing it.
Okay. Hi, I'm Bethany, and I matched into pediatrics at Case Western Rainbow Babies.
All right. Hi, I'm Rachel Warchuk, and I matched emergency medicine at Vanderbilt.
Hi, I'm Kobe Booth. I matched family medicine at Trinity Health in Grand Rapids.
Hey, everybody. My name is Colin Vassar, and I matched internal medicine at the University of Tennessee, Nashville.
My name is Caitlin Van Riper, and I matched family medicine at my first choice in Memorial Hospital in South Bend, Indiana.
Hi, I'm Emily Carroll, and I applied to triple board pediatrics, psychiatry, and child psychiatry programs, and I matched at Cincinnati Children's Hospital.
It's Friday, my dudes. My name's Nirvan. I'm here to tell you that I matched MedPeds at Wayne State University. Go Lions!
Hi, everybody. My name is Taylor Floth. I'm going into neurology at the University of Washington. Go Dogs.
I am Samuel Ferris. I matched emergency medicine.
And I'm Haley Barker. I matched internal medicine.
We're both very excited to announce that we matched
Thomas Jefferson in Philadelphia.
Is it me?
Where are you?
Go ahead.
Hi, everyone. My name is Mfani Sil, and I matched Duke University in North Carolina, and I applied neurology.
All right, how's it going? My name is Brian. Matched emergency medicine at University of California, Irvine.
How you doing? My name is Zane. I matched Maimonides in Brooklyn for psychiatry.
Hey, congrats, everyone. My name is Eamon. I match general surgery at Garden City.
Hi, I'm Abby. I match psych at Medical College of Wisconsin.
Hi, my name is Becca Parr. I matched at my number one spot at Naples Hospital in internal medicine.
Hi, my name is Tyler Burgess. I matched internal medicine and I'm going back home to UCSF Fresno.
Hi, Patrick Renner, General Surgery, Spectrum Hospital in Grand Rapids. Does anyone else want the microphone?
My name is Rachel Tulsma, and I matched orthopedic surgery at the University of Wisconsin.
Hi, everyone. My name is Emily, and I matched into general surgery at Dartmouth.
Oops, sorry for the delay. I'm Tracy. I matched in family medicine at Sparrow and Lansing.
Hello, everyone. My name is Alex Chavez, and we matched at West Virginia University.
Hi all, my name is Peter Beck. I'm going into family medicine at St. Joe in South Bend or Mishawaka, Indiana.
What'd you say? No, it is a different program.
Hello everyone, my name is Andrew Gray. I matched to my number one choice at Legacy Health in Portland, Oregon, in medicine.
Hey everybody, I'm Amy Lorber. I'm matching into pediatrics, and I'm also going to Portland, Oregon, Oregon Health and Sciences University.
Woo! Hey everyone, I'm Christine, and I matched into rural family medicine at Oregon Health and Sciences University in Klamath Falls, Oregon.
I'm Max Jin. I applied internal medicine, and I'll be going to AGH in Pittsburgh.
I'm Riley Scanlon. I matched into family medicine with Aspirus Health in Wausau, Wisconsin.
Hi, everybody. I'm Claudia Waters, and I am going home to northern Wisconsin to Marshfield Clinic for internal medicine. Go, Pack, go!
Hi, everybody. My name is Andrew Lynch, and I will be here at Western Michigan University for obstetrics and gynecology.
I matched into rural family medicine at North Country in Flagstaff, Arizona.
Hello.
All right, so if we have any more students that decide they want to share, we'll leave the mic. In the meantime, feel free to make sure you put your marks up there so we know where everybody's going across the country. All right, we got a couple more takers.
I'm Ryan. I matched family medicine in University of Minnesota Methodist.
I'm Janelle.
I'm David.
We couples match. I'll be studying pathology at University of Michigan.
And I'll be here for family medicine.